Ladies and gentlemen, the Prime Minister of Thailand, Her Excellency, Ms. Ying Lakshinawat, will arrive in a few minutes.
And it's a wonderful thing because it's helped us raise the profile of information security. Look at the press. And it's a great thing. So, Your Excellency, I'd like to invite a warm round of applause and as we welcome Her Excellency Ms. Yinwat Shinwat to the podium. Just welcome us.
Thank you very much. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure to speak at the 25th Annual Conference of the Forum of Incident Response and Security Team, or FIRST, here in Bangkok. May I extend a warm welcome to over 250 security experts and professionals from all over the world. So I can't believe all experts is in this room. Maybe only me that I'm not the expert, but I know how important of this job. So that's why we are here, and that's why I am here. As the conference team suggests, we are here to promote sharing to win by exchanging experience on how to address the threat of cyber security. According to the World Bank, in 2010, around 30% of the world's households and individuals have access to the internet. These trends are growing. In Thailand, there are 24 million internet users and 87 million mobile phone numbers out of a population of 64 million. This increase in internet and mobile phone user globally and technological advance in ICT have led to create more opportunities. Transaction costs for business have gone down. And at the same time, there are now greater access to global markets. Enhanced connectivity has led to greater trade, investment, and tourism. SME and micro businesses now have an important tool to be more successful in the globalized world. And it is also helping us in realize an ASEAN communities by 2015. Other areas have benefited. Better ICT has supported education through initiatives such as the One Tablet Per Child policy here in Thailand. Access to medical care has increased through telemedicine as well. ICT and the internet have empowered people, making them better informed and more productive citizens. That is why we have the Smart Thailand initiative to help more people, especially those in the rural areas, to gain access to the internet. Ladies and gentlemen, but like other technological developments, there is a great potential for misuse as we are so connected. Cyber threat affect industry and commerce. National securities and the welfare of the people, in particular, our children. According to ThaiSearch, nearly 800 cyber threat reports were received in 2012. This increased virus and worms, as well as action by hackers. Without legal and technological safeguard, the potential of digital economy cannot be realized. More importantly, all of us will not feel safe and secure. To address this challenge, Thailand has recently established the National Cyber Security Committee, which I chair. We are developing a national cyber security policy framework that will help create synergies from cooperation between government agencies, business, civil societies, and the general public. This framework will cover issues such as governance, emergency readiness, developing a national critical information infrastructure, and capacity building. I also recognize the need for better public awareness and training of officers. This is to strengthen the country's cyber defense against online attack and cyber criminal. To help achieve this, regional and international cooperation is critical. This is one threat where no single country can address alone. That is why, at the regional level, Thailand fully supports enhanced ASEAN cooperation to fight cybercrime, which is one of the ASEAN 8 priorities area in transnational crimes. Indeed, if ASEAN is to enjoy enhanced connectivity fully, it will need to protect the cyberspace from threat. We also support the ASEAN Regional Forum's ARF efforts to develop a work plan on cyber security, bringing together experts and ideas from across the Asia Pacific. And at the global level, we have this important first initiative, which will allow member teams from around the world to find ways to better protect us from cyber threats. Whether it is better sharing of information or developing new technologies, this first conference will continue to play an important role, as I mentioned earlier. That's why we are here, and I think we will have the, I expect that we will have the very useful information to connect together and share the information among our countries in the world. That is to ensure that cyberspace remains a secure frontier to knowledge building and a safe platform to promote progress and prosperity of all, for all. So, in light of the great opportunities and challenges, I wish this conference much success. I hope that through the cooperation and networking between us, we will be stronger in our collective abilities to manage cyber threats. May I also wish you a pleasant stay in Thailand as you enjoy our world-renowned hospitalities. Welcome again to Thailand. Thank you very much.
I would like to express our sincere gratitude to Your Excellency, Ms. Ying Lakshinawat. And may I ask Your Excellency to be on the stage a little longer. On this special occasion, may I invite Mr. Chris Gibson, Chair First ORG, to give the Prime Minister a souvenir. Invite Your Excellency and Mr. Chris Gibson to remain on a stage a little longer. Next, may I invite the Shibos and honorable guests to take a photo together. impressive and memorable picture of the beginning of the 25th official annual first conference. Of course, this is an auspicious occasion for us to collaborate to solve the problem on the cybersecurity at international level. And now, may I ask all of the participants to applaud and express their gratitude to Your Excellency, Ms. Ding Lakshinawat, the Prime Minister of Thailand, for coming to be a